Hello Galaxy Commanders and welcome to this video for Infinite Galaxy. As promised, I did spend quite a lot of time and I did a little bit, not only a little bit, a lot of research. I attacked so many pirates, I am surprised there are still pirates left in my system. But let's talk about what I'm going to show you now. I came up with a few fleet setups based on combinations of different flagships. I did test them all versus pirates. I did change the warships that I was using. I did try a lot of stuff. And I tried to come out with some kind of advice, rule of thumbs, because I know not everyone will have the same flagships available. Not everyone will have the possibility to get them at the same rank and so on and so on. Before we get to this, I just finished my space plan, so I got the last level here. And just want to take a quick look with you into what you get when you buy this. So this is, it's really a lot. You do get a lot of Corium, you do get additional Federation credits. Okay, that's not really that much. We have 1,000 advanced Federation credits here. You do get a few citation devices, but you also get quite a lot of resources. And all of this for around $10. So as usual, I don't want to recommend anyone to buy something. But if you're someone who says, I am spending money in the game, it's not really a bad deal. It's pretty nice looking into 4 million deuterium and titanium. I am not really a big fan of A-Rich, but also there right now with all the crew members that we need, he may not be completely useless when you can rank him up to get his additional fleet leadership. But yeah, just wanted to point that out. So let's go into flagships. I will make an updated flagship tier list, but I can already tell you it doesn't change much. The best flagship still for PvE is the Prometheus. There's no way around the Prometheus if you want to be super strong in PvE. The best overall flagship still is the Cyclops. And we did take a look at the warship changes in the last video. If you missed this, check out the last video and take a look. I tell you how the stats changed and so on. Cyclops is very strong, and also the Cyclops Awakening skill is increasing cruiser attack by 25 up to 50%. This is huge. If you look at something like the Prometheus, it reduces the warship attack from the enemy, or what else do we have here? Achilles. Total warship attack reduction. Probably very popular will be Artemis, increasing frigate armor, so defensive skills. Hades, increasing destroyer attack, but only by 15 and 30% because it got a second skill here, increasing destroyer armor. Titan, also very popular at the moment, decreasing total warship armor. So if you ask me, I would immediately go with the Awakening skill from the Cyclops. Increasing attack is usually the best thing you can do, so that's just an extra note there. First, a little disclaimer. I do have a lot of flagships here, as you can see. There are only two missing, but I do not have all of them ranked up very high. So comparing something like what I was able to compare was a Hercules. I got it up to rank 6, and I compare it to a Prontus, which is rank 9 at the moment. I can tell you I was surprised, at least for Marauders, the Hercules performs nearly as good as a Prontus. The reason for this is in the skills. Hercules, and same also for the Prometheus. These skills are always active, no matter what. If you fight versus NPCs, these skills are active. For our Brontës, first skill is active, second skill only versus frigates, and if you now have cruiser heavy fleet, which you very likely will have if you run a Brontës or a Cyclops, you will attack these stupid frigates last. So it's a little bit disappointing. Second, so yeah, second, third, fourth, fifth skill only as long as your HP is higher than 70%. And if you attack something solo, your HP will drop below 70% very quickly. That is the reason why the Hercules performs better in these kind of fights, as it just gives you this bonus all the time. So now you could say, okay, I just combine a Prometheus with a Hercules. This will be an amazing team if you fight pirates or any other NPCs. But what are you doing with your second, third, and maybe even fourth fleet? So you will have to set up some combinations. I did try the combination of Cyclops with Brontës, which is working, but changing out one of these versus Hercules or Prometheus was just so much better. You can also go for Artemis or for Hades if you want to. Very, very good ships. I would probably go for the Hades just because it can get one of the passes. It increases the navigation speed for everything, so no matter what you put inside there, two times. You do get additional destroyer range, which will be really nice in alliance events if your destroyers stay behind your alliance destroyers. And it got also a small attack boost on its awakening skill. So based on all of this, one important thing to note, I figured out your secondary auxiliary fleet does not use its or does not apply its first skill fleet effect. I already talked with Camel, and I'm not sure if this is a bug or if it's supposed to be like this, but only the weapon fleet effect from the first flagship is applied to your fleet. Also keep in mind that legendary flagships do have, if they are fully unlocked, one additional slot for weapons and defensive gear. So as you see, for my Cyclops this is still locked. For my Prometheus, because I'm playing on server 2, this is unlocked. This means you have to see how you set up your fleet. I did a test here where I put the Hercules on the second slot, the Cyclops on the first slot, and this does not make sense. Let's go back to the flagship, because my Hercules has four weapon slots. The problem there, it increases missile attack. My Cyclops only has three and gives 10% kinetic weapons. My weapons that I use do give more than 10%, they give 15%. So meaning having this additional slot at the moment makes the Hercules the better lead in this fleet combination. Now, as soon as I get to rank 6, this will change, and I'm already at rank 4. I plan to increase the rank of my Cyclops as soon as possible. So what I'm going to run is, I will run a Prometheus with a Brontës. I will run a Cyclops with a Hercules. This gives me two additional options. For pure PvE, I can, if I really need to push, combine the Hercules with the Prometheus, and as soon as it comes to PvP, I can combine the Brontës with the Cyclops. Now, for the third fleet, I'm a little bit unsure, not completely decided yet. Having Hades there will be great. So I'm thinking about getting the Hades, but it does not open me a lot of additional potential for PvP. I was thinking about adding a Titan, but I don't have enough Titan blueprints. If you have a lot of Titan blueprints and you do not want to reset it, the Titan is a great addition for PvP, not for PvE. You can also use Atlas if you want to. It will be a little bit easier to skill up, but if you are good in Galaxy Star Event and you gather a lot of blueprints there, this might be a really good option. The Tezos also, if you do not use the Prometheus, getting a Tezos up is pretty easy because you can buy the blueprints in the campaign shop and they are pretty cheap. You do get warship HP, armor, shield. You do get PvP skills here, warship attack, warship shield, especially now with the change of the warship shield. Increasing the shield is pretty interesting. And then at last one, you do get additional armor as long as your fleet HP is higher than 70%. Running a pure fleet of like Cyclops with Prontus, it's not bad. I will do this for PvP alliance events where I might be able to get my fleet behind something. Running a Prometheus with a Hercules is amazing, but as you need to set up three, maybe even four fleets, you need to start combining these. And instead of getting one very strong fleet and then another very weak or medium fleet, I will go the way to have two strong fleets. So I have both of them set up with cruisers, and they have a Cyclops Hercules, or in this case Prometheus Prontus. The third fleet, as said, I'm not exactly sure. The fourth fleet was very simple. It's Achilles plus Peleus. And for captain, I use Bold and Amiga. So let me show this to you. Why am I doing this? I do get an additional load from Bold here, and I do get planet development resource output 27%, as he is at the moment skilled. Using Amiga will give me additional output for titanium and deuterium 57%, which is a lot. Sure, it does not help me for gathering any kind of like nickel or plasma, but it increases up to 57% for deuterium, and therefore I do mine planets for deuterium and titanium, and I do mine asteroids for nickel and plasma. Good. The other captains, and now it's getting difficult because in theory we need eight captains, and this is also something I try to talk with Camel about. We do not really have enough crew members, if you ask me. Let's take a look. Let's sort them by rarity. We do have 2, 4, 6, 8, if we count the kit, 9 legendary crew members. We do have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17 epic crew members. But out of all these crew members, we only have 12 crew members that are combat oriented. We can put a total of 12 crew members in our crew formation. So if I want to have combat oriented crew members, I will have to start replacing my captains with blue crew members here in the crew formation. And as you see, I already have two blue ones, one green one inside here. That's a downside. I don't see any way around there. You can use someone like Laura just for the additional points and stuff like this. I will probably put her as captain. Because with the strength of the fleet now, it is really important that you get a very strong crew set up there. Okay, so I hope this gave you a good idea about the flagship auxiliary system and how I would set it up. As said, I will run a combination of Brontes, Prometheus, Cyclops, Hercules, which I will switch over to Prometheus with Hercules to push PvE solo, and to Cyclops and Brontes for PvP. And then the third fleet will be PvP oriented. Either it will be Hades with something, or it will be Titan with something. That I still can use it for PvE as third fleet, so it will not be like two PvP ships, but
Flagship.
very likely because of the amount of Federation credits I have, I will go maybe with a Theseus and Radamantis, something like this. It's easy to set up, it is pretty cheap. I can start getting Theseus blueprints from the campaign shop while I use Federation credits to rank up the Radamantis. This way, I can use all my advanced Federation credits and put them into the Cyclops, that it really gets strong. I continue upgrading my Prometheus, probably, yeah, for sure till rank 7, so that I can unlock at least the first skill here, the Glorious Holy Flame. I don't think I can get it up to 9. So getting a legendary flagship up to rank 9 to get the second level of the Awakening skill requires a lot of resources. If you are lucky enough to have these resources, go for it. This is great. I will try to get my Cyclops as high that I at least can get one. I will try to get my Prometheus high enough to get one, so that I have two fleets with Awakening skill, and therefore my third fleet will be a little bit crippled. I will very likely not use a legendary flagship as long as I lack the resources to rank it up high enough there. Okay, share your combinations and how you set them up, how you handle the ranking challenge that we have right now. Share this in the comments with me. I'm really curious about that. Please do me a favor, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and then I'll see you all on the next video again.